Okie dokie. So we've got no Lemon Mega Campaign runs yet, so we're starting from zero. Her Mega Weapons is obviously a Mega Spreadshot. It's a Mega version of her normal-ass Spreadshot, so... Not really a big fan of Lemon's spread as her primary, but maybe the Mega one will go a little bit better. So let's get going. In 3, 2, 1, go, 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 go. All right, let's go. Let's go. See what we got. Oh, it even bounces too. Oh, that's pretty fucking rad, actually. That is okay by me. Still not the greatest damage, apparently, but it does something. It's a little something something. I would have preferred her rockets, to be honest with you, but that's okay. It's alright. We'll make things work. We'll make things work, especially since it bounces a little bit. That's pretty cool. We might be able to pull some weird corner shots or something. But who knows? Who knows? I would have expected to get that little white flyer there, but apparently did not work as such. So it's pretty much going to be standard MO for Lemon to do any sort of reasonable damage with the primaries to just get super up in some business. So that's what we're going to have to do with the Mega Weapon as well. The bounce back distance is kind of weird, honestly. Not the best mega weapon. It's almost better to use the normal one, honestly. You don't rely on the mega one. Not too bad, I guess. I don't know if it's gonna necessarily be any faster than the rockets. But hey, buck 10, sure. Unfortunately. Battery up. Firepower. Firepower extended. Weapon max. Battery here. Firepower extended.
I'm getting the feel for this.
It's almost better just to spray and pray with her shit. That's weird. That's weird. Feels not great. I can see why Mega Weapon scores don't count on the leaderboards, because this just feels... Lemon just feels even more handicapped than she already is with her Mega Spread rather than rockets. Yeah, whatever. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Wasted damage. I don't like it. At least with the rockets, you can be sort of precise. Put the hurt where you need it and such. But here, it's just kind of wasteful. Say it does do a pretty good job of cleaning the room of trash mobs, though. We'll give it that. We'll give it that. It's 345,000 even. Oh, good. Boss fights are gonna be another real pain in the arse, aren't they? Dang. I guess it does do some really good damage if you can concentrate it. Get right up in there and do the business with it. Okay. Alright. You gotta be real careful with it, I suppose. You gotta get really up in there. Otherwise it just leaks out all over the place. Okay. Okay. Alright, eat shit, Embryo. 48 seconds? It's not terrible. Not the most terrible we've ever seen. See this being heckin' useful for wasps, though, considering they're the trashiest mobs of all. This is a little bit more conventional than Holly's Mega Seeker, certainly, since that had a tendency to focus down on each individual trash mob, which was very bad.
Alright, who's next?
So at least it's got less of a penchant for screwing itself over. I wonder how this would fare in Campaign Plus Influx right at the end, when it's got that real tight labyrinth. I would guess it would do alright. Maybe not the greatest, but at least it would focus some of the wasted DPS.
Next.
me.
Okay, that works pretty good for getting around the curve. And concentrating it down a bit. Thanks to ye olde physics. On this level. Vespi's gonna be interesting. Certainly no ball strat available to us. Well, actually that may or may not be true. Yeah, that's true. Because we can't penetrate the... ball still has collision for shots. This is gonna be interesting. Nah, we don't have much of an opportunity to get too close to her. So Vespi's probably gonna still remain the biggest pain in the ass boss. Enemy down. Oh, thought we could do a little coward ball strat there. Womp. Such luck. Okay, so you can still get right up in there. It's very hard to judge how close is too close. Okay. Vespi is still a pain in the ass, confirmed. circular rooms are pretty good, as long as they're not too large. Just take advantage of the bounce back. Damn thing, really? Heat went pretty well there.
Alright, who's next?
Buck 29.
Firepower. Battery over here. Thank you.
There'd be one just hopping around outside. Gleam. Had a couple get stuck behind the outer wall. 203 though, okay. Ah, dust. It's gonna be interesting trying to shove our mega spread right in his face, huh? Ooh, managed it okay, except for that last bit. Up in there. It's weird that it kind of bounced off of the back of his collision box there. And back inwards, so we'll take it. Weird as it is, we'll take it. There. And he was just about almost dead anyways.
Battery here.
Oh, come on, really? Silly. Come on, excuse me. That rockets would have nuked them the first time out. Hey, up and thanks for the raid. How's everybody doing tonight? Be fast, please. I'm trying to be fast. I'm trying so hard to be fast. Sometimes it's very difficult. No such thing as an easy speedrun, I can assure you. Actually, that's not true. I'm sure there are some very easy speedruns out there. And mega weapons aren't too hard to use, honestly. Because if you're used to the primary weapons, you'll be used to the mega weapons pretty easily. Despite my best efforts to throw this away at the beginning of the level.
Alright, who's next?
Covered it and still made it a sub 3. Right through there, sure. Turret there.
Battery over here. Lighting him up, knocking him down. Firepower extended. Accelerate. I'm just getting started. Battery here. Accelerate extended.
Terrible, we took it dumbed down in the middle there somewheres. Firepower. Nearly forgot about the mines. I have my split set to remind me about the mines. And I almost always forget about them. But we won't forget about the second set. I hope. By one of them. Nice. Oh, come on, really? Had better looking repeaters there. That's okay. Still well below 3 minutes. Dang. That was pretty good there. Our butts right in there. Didn't do that. Love it. Here, because for exactly that reason. Goodness. Last couple phases. Oh boy, that multi-turret phase in the middle did not go great. Swap through that one. Wasn't gonna work. crash fire of a centrifuge. Had better controls. We've also had much worse controls, so whatever. All balances out in the end, right? Off that far wall. Thank you. Okay. Reasonable convection. Alright, who's next? 37, sure. Accelerates just in a couple sections before we face Linker. For the firepower. Well, now this isn't gonna be fair for her, really. We've got so many projectiles floating around that are gonna be mine. Of course, I can no longer one-shot her with a rocket, but that's okay. I feel like that's made up for the fact that I can literally carpet bomb everywhere else. Let's keep her away from that, dang it. I gotta keep that for myself for an accelerate, but... escape it though. Eh? There we go. Easy peasy.
Alright, who's next?
221 licorice. Alright. Very good. Very good. We might still pull a sub 50 out of this. If we'd have to fuck up pretty big to not get a sub 50, I suppose, so let's not fuck up pretty big then. Thought about it, I've decided to not fuck up pretty big. Bullets on her, but that's all right. Ooh, nice dance. Kind of a little worried about that. Clean initial phases.
Alright.
That almost got them all. Incredible. Spin to win. Sub 48.
Alright, who's next?
4734. That's pretty reasonable baseline.
These readings make no sense.
There are a couple levels that were really shitty. We took stupid downs, and pretty much any level we took a down in is probably pretty stupid. But at least we've now got a baseline for Lemon. Excuse me. And we can move on to the next.